Myself, Kamlesh Thakkar, Assistant Professor, Vilasa Girls College, Department of Physics. Today I delivered a lecture on a very famous topic of our physics, and we changed the classical physics. This topic is photoelectric effect. In photoelectric effect, we know the quantum theory is satisfied, and the quantum theory according to the scientist Albert Einstein. So I conclude this total topic in this points introduction, working in work function and electronics, Earth's observation, Lennard's experiments, laws of photoelectric effect, failure of classical theories, Planck's hypothesis, and Einstein's photoelectric equations, and last one, the explanation of laws of photoelectric effect by quantum theory. Next. So what is photoelectric effect? First, photo that means not a photo that means the radiation, that means visible and invisible light. And electricity, that means due to the visible or invisible light or due to the radiation, we easily emit the electricity. So for this purpose, scientist H.R. Hertz in 1887 see the experiment, and in 1902 Lennard's experiment also, and Planck theory, and then several scientists, finally Albert Einstein complete this theory and prove that the quantum theory is very good to explain the photoelectric effect. Next, to understand the photoelectric effect, first of all we have to know about the two main things. One is the work function, and second one is the electron emission. What is work function? Work function, that means the minimum energy which is required to emit the electron from any metallic surface. So every surface has some electron, every metallic surface has some electron in their surface. So we have to emit the electron, so we have to provide some energy. This energy is provided by the radiations. Okay, so work function is the minimum energy, and the unit of the work function is in electron volt, which is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 power. And the maximum of the work function is the platinum, and the minimum is the cesium. And next one is the electron emissions. Next one. Electron emission, that means the phenomena of emission of electron from any metallic surface is called electron emission. In electron emission, there are several parts of the electron emission, like harmonic emission due to temperature, field emission due to electric field, high electric field, and secondary emission due to one particle emitted collide, and second particle is emitted. And another one is last important is photoelectric emission, that means the emission of electron due to radiation. So Hertz experiment or observation. You see that this diagram shows the cathode, there are no any connection between the cathode and anode. But whenever we incident the light on the cathode, that means ultraviolet radiation incident in the cathode, then some electron is emitted and going towards the anode. So which can be measured in the by milliampere. This current is called the photoelectric current. And the electron which is emitted from the cathode is called the photoelectron. Now this phenomena is called the photoelectric according to Hertz experiment. Next, so Lennard experiment, if you see this diagram, Lennard explained that if we change the something, change the some property of radiation, like intensity, like frequency, in incident radiation, then what happens? So the light is incident in cathode, and if we change the intensity of light, then the number of electrons is changed. That means if we increase the intensity of light, then the number of electrons increases. Which electron? Photoelectron. And if we change the frequency of incident light, suppose we change the increase the frequency of light, then what happens? Then the energy of this electron, kinetic energy of this electron is increased. The most important thing is the intensity, increase the number of electrons, and frequency, increase the kinetic energy of the electrons. Next. Some important points here I collect, which is related to the Lennard's experiment. Lennard also get a Nobel Prize for this phenomena. So effect of intensity of incident radiation, I will explain. The photoelectric effect phenomena, the photoelectric current is directly proportional to the intensity of incident light. That means if we increase the intensity, then photoelectric current is increases. Effect of potential difference, this is very important for us. Here a point in dark matter is right here, stopping potential. Stopping potential, what is stopping potential? So when we see, another thing. anode have the positive potential if we change the anode by this variable voltage. If we change the potential of the anode by this variable voltage, suppose we decrease the potential of anode, positive to decrease zero, then we decrease negative. So it is clear the electron is emitted from the cathode, okay, but there are no any electron is going towards the anode, cathode to anode. Why? Because then you change the terminal of anode, potential of anode. If the anode has negative potential, then how can any electron going from the cathode to anode? So what we have to do? Then we change the radiations. Then we change the frequency of it. When we change the frequency of radiation, we see that the electron is going towards from the cathode. That means frequency increase the kinetic energy of electron. So electron is going towards the cathode. Okay, but if after this no electron is going towards the cathode, then the potential of anode, is called the stopping potential. What is the stopping potential? The stopping potential is the potential of anode for which no any electron is going from cathode to anode. Okay, next. This is some graph on stopping potential, also for saturation current and stopping potential. And this is this graph is very important for us, because wave theory always tells us about the whenever light is in the form of wave and incident with any metallic surface, then electron is emitted, current is flow, but there are no any particular frequencies required to emit the electron. But here, the quantum theory tells us, or explain and mathematically, that there are some minimum frequencies required to emit the electron from any metallic surface, even though the intensity is very high. But minimum frequency is required to emit the electron from any metallic surface, and this minimum frequency is called the threshold frequency. Below threshold frequency, only work function, but after threshold frequency, maximum kinetic energy we can get, that means electron is moving. Without threshold frequency or above, below threshold frequency, electron is not moved from cathode to anode. Next. So loss of photoelectric effect, and collect some points, important points of the loss of the photoelectric effect, just 1 minute more. Number of photoelectrons directly proportional to intensity, we know after this phenomena study. Number of photoelectrons and minimum frequency, we know the minimum frequency required to emit the electron from any metallic surfaces. What? Threshold frequency, kinetic energy is depending on the frequency, not depending on the intensity. What is the failure of wave theory? We know last one thing is, when wave is come, if wave theory is okay, we agree with wave theory. If wave is coming to any surface and collide with the surface, then there are some time taking by the wave to emit the electron. That means there are some lag time between two incident wave and emitted electron. But in quantum theory, last point, there are no time lag between incident radiation and emitted. Okay. Next, we can also explain this theory by photoelectric effect equation, which is given by the Albert Einstein. Oh, it is okay for you. Thank you very much.